Mark My Words Productions.
People often say, what is God? What people often say, what is God? What is not God is the question I pose to you instead.
Well, that's a good take on it, but the answer is the same. You know how people say everything is God? Well, the answer is nothing is not God. Everything is God. I mean, it's the same answer in a sense, just the opposite way. Nothing is not God. And that also goes in with evil, quote-unquote evil. I don't believe in evil in the sense of how people believe in evil. I just look at it as a positive and negative side to it now in my understanding. But people, you know what is funny to me is that there are people say, you know, everything is God, but yet then they want to say, but Hitler wasn't God. Hitler was evil, or George Bush is not God. You know, how can everything be God and you leave out Hitler and George Bush or men like that of not being God? That is so not the case. I mean, really, if that's the case, then now you're judging God. You're judging what God is. And if God is everything, then there's no way that people like that cannot be God. You know, so they're God too. They're just going through their own experience with it, with their experience here. And yes, they have their own karma coming into their own life for their own actions that has played out in their lives. But God loves those beings just as much as God loves Gandhi, you know, or Martin Luther King, you know. And it's very funny to me, a lot of Christians want to condemn Hitler and say he's going to hell, when really the whole religion is based off forgiveness. So how can they call themselves Christians if they can't forgive one of the most gruesome things that has ever happened in the history of man that we know of?
Yeah.
You know, it's about forgiveness, and that's a huge test. That's a huge test. You know, okay, fine, you can forgive somebody stealing $5 from you. Okay, fine, you can forgive somebody stepping on your sneakers. Okay, fine, but can you forgive somebody who committed genocide? And was trying to wipe out a whole race? That's true forgiveness, you know. That's true forgiveness, you know. And it's not just that; it goes into slavery too with black people, you know. Can you forgive that whole situation that happened and move on and stop having these hang-ups? You know, I mean, it goes through every aspect of life of that you feel that is so unforgiving. No, if you want to be that forgiving person, you know, those are things that you got to work on too. And that goes on with me. And I understand it's harder because we are in these human bodies, what we think we are, but we think we're so separate from everything, from everybody. So what comes back into play is me. I can't believe they did this to me, or why didn't they think about me when they were doing this? Or, you know, it all comes at me. But really, it's really 1-1-1-1. So in the grand scheme of things, that's why they're all accepting and all forgiving, because you're doing everything to yourself anyway. So why wouldn't you forgive yourself at the end of the day? We don't see that here. We just see the separatism. We see me and you, you know. But so it is hard, but and it's very understandable. You know, but I mean, the grand scheme of things, whether you want to forgive somebody here or not, really, it's irrelevant, because you eventually will at the end of the day.